Fine. In the previous session, in the last session that I concluded yesterday, we talked about generation of FM signals using two methods. So if you want to just browse through the sessions that we had done yesterday, we discussed about two methods of generation. One was indirect method of generation using Armstrong modulator. I just gave an overview about this type of modulation, which we don't have in detail for our syllabus. However, we discussed in detail about direct method of generation, where we directly vary the voltage of the message signal. I mean, we directly vary the frequency of the carrier in accordance with the message signal. So this M of T being the message signal is varied using voltage control oscillator. So you can implement this kind of modulation using any of the configurations, or either using op amp in Schmitt trigger mode, or just using varactor. It could be diode varactors or MOS varactors, or simply it can be done using your Hartley or Colpitts oscillator configurations. Okay, so we discussed about Colpitts oscillator, where we varied the capacitance of the tank in accordance with the message signal, thereby changing its oscillation frequency. Okay, so that's how we discussed mathematically about the variation of frequency with respect to the voltage. And hence, we also concluded that the deviation, delta C, which is a capacitance deviation, or the variation in capacitance, doesn't much contribute much into the harmonics or the problem associated with the modulation. Okay, so this was done with the transmission part of FM signal. Now we need to do the exact opposite part of it, which is detection or the demodulation. Okay, so we'll begin today's session now with demodulation of FM waves. Again, in similar with the lines of modulation, demodulation also comes with a variety of flavors. So demodulation usually done in importantly in with two ways. One is using a slope detector plus followed by an envelope detector. Okay, so envelope detector you might have studied in your demodulation of AM waves. A similar method is used to demodulate FM waves as well, but it is followed by the slope detector. Slope detector is mathematically, it can be called as a differentiator. Okay, we'll see this as the first type. And the second type that we are going to discuss today, an important part of the transceivers, in fact, both in transmitter and receiver, you will be seeing an important component called as phase locked loop. So this being the heart of the transmitter and receiver in modern communication system. Okay, in short, it is called as PLL. So we are going to address these two types of demodulation and try to conclude the first half of this unit, at least as a conceptual point of view. All right, so we'll begin with the slope detector first. So the slope detector plus envelope detector can also be called as using a differentiator. Say the first one using, you can say now, as a differentiator. We'll analyze this both qualitatively and quantitatively. We'll try to understand the working principle behind demodulation. We know that to begin with, the FM modulated wave S of T, we know that this is given as AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integral 0 to T M of tau d tau. Okay, so this is your FM modulated wave. So FM signal, frequency modulated signal, is given mathematically like this. If you try observing, you know, a little carefully, our job is to extract message signal here. So message signal is hidden in the argument. In turn, it is in the integral part of it in a mathematical sense. We need to extract now message signal from this complex mathematical relation. So the straightforward method is to take out this m of t from the integral by using a differentiator. So let's try to apply differentiation, the first order differentiation, and let's see how this mathematically would look like. Say the first order differentiation d by dt of s of t will give us this is ac cos theta, so it is your minus ac sine of the complete argument, which is 2 pi fc t plus 2 pi kf 0 to t m of tau d tau into the differentiation inside the square braces. So into differentiation of 2 pi fct plus 2 pi kf 0 to t m of tau d tau. Okay, so if I try to perform differentiation of the second term, as you can see, this will give me 2 pi fc plus 2 pi kf. It's integration of the same variable, so we can take out that integration which cancels with the differentiation, and we can extract m of t from that. So if I try to rearrange the terms, and this will be minus ac times, I will get 2 pi fc plus 2 pi kf times m of t as the amplitude, okay, times sine, and rest of the argument will be retained as it is. 2 pi kf integral m of tau d tau. Alright, so now we are looking to extract the information of message signal. Now it is seen in the amplitude of this time varying function. So sine of something is a time varying function. This could be periodic or aperiodic. We are not concerned about this, but what we are looking or what we are focusing is its amplitude. So where its amplitude involves some constants plus the variation with respect to the message signal. So if we try to pass this, say this is nothing but my envelope of this waveform, say this is the amplitude, which is called as the envelope, by which I mean the amplitude. So this is envelope of differentiator output. Okay, by differentiating you have arrived at this particular equation, and which gives the amplitude in this manner. Now if you try to pass this complete signal through an envelope detector, which detects the envelope of this complete wave, we are good to extract the message signal. Okay, so that I can write the complete block diagram in this fashion. Say your s of t, which is your FM wave, which is incoming, which is passed through a differentiator. Say a differentiator I can write as d by dt of the input signal which is applied to it, then it is passed through an envelope detector which performs the detection of the amplitude, and hence slope detector, this is also called as differentiator, can also be termed as slope detector. So this can also be termed as the slope detector. As you know, the differentiation is nothing but the slope of any function that is applied to it. Say we can demodulate the message signal. So I'll not write m of t here. I can say recovered message signal.
So
right. So this is how you can try getting an information about message signal. Yes.
one doubt.
Yes, please, go ahead.
Isn't differentiating with respect to carrier frequency makes no
sense? Yes, please ask.
Instead of differentiating it to
Differentiation with respect to carrier frequency. See, you are not differentiating with respect to frequency here. You are differentiating with respect to time domain because my message signal is variation in time. Okay, so we want to extract the complete information about m of t. Okay, so differentiation with respect to frequency doesn't give any useful quantity because this will still be intact as it is. It will be in the integral part.
You are detecting the envelope, that is
the right after getting the envelope. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll talk about this. You need not use any more differentiation. Apart from this. So you have got envelope detector, which will give this amplitude. You don't need anything more in the circuitry to get the information of message signal, because as you can see very closely here. Okay. I'll just try to answer your question. If you try to the output of say envelope detector is nothing but AC. If I take just the magnitude of it, say this is, I can write this as 2 pi AC. If I try to multiply with AC here, so this is 2 pi AC times, so 2 pi is common here, so which is FC plus KF times m of t. Okay, I'll just answer your question immediately now. 2 pi AC, if I take FC also common, what I'm left here is KF times m of t over FC. Okay, as you can see, this is just a constant term here. Okay, this is just a constant which is varying with respect to the carrier frequency. AC is fixed, your FC is also fixed. So these two are the constant terms. What is varying here is KF is also constant because you have fixed your frequency deviation and the carrier frequency. So KF is also fixed, carrier frequency is also fixed. So only the variable here is m of t. So if you can extract this information where only the term varying here is message signal, you need not use any other block following the envelope detector. This itself will reveal what is the property of your message signal. Okay, I understand your doubt that if you try to differentiate with respect to frequency, you may pull this to zero and you'll have just message signal. I need not do that. I need not go for finer tuning of detection of message signal because I'll be incurring a more amount of blocks in the circuitry, or it may incur more cost. But this is more than enough to find out the information of the message signal. Okay, okay. For envelope detection, the signal condition is that signal should not be overmodulated. So as you know that in case of overmodulation, in amplitude modulation as well, for overmodulation there would you see the phase reversals where it would come to the negative sides and it fall back to the positive side again. So there is also certain condition for envelope detection. Say if for no distortion, say for no envelope distortion. Okay, so if you don't want to incur any envelope distortion here, you can force a condition where, as you can see here, the only variable is m of t. We don't want the envelope of this FM signal, because we know that frequency modulated signal, unlike your AM signal, has constant amplitude. Okay, so this has constant amplitude. There is no variation with respect to amplitude, but there is only variation with respect to the frequency, right? So we don't want the variation in the envelope with respect to message signal. So to force that condition, I want the numerator to be as less when compared to the denominator. So if I say, if FC, the carrier frequency, if it is much, much greater than KF times M of T, then I will have the envelope of the output of envelope detector will not vary much with respect to the message signal. This may not happen because of the carrier, but this may happen with the distortion in the channel itself, due to the signals attenuated or reflected by the various objects in the wireless media. There could be variation in the output of envelope detector. To suppress that or to have that condition for having no distortion, you can force this mathematical relation. Of course, in spite of this setup, you may incur the distortions in the envelope, but there are other methods to tackle them using hard limiter and bandpass limiter. We are not going to look at those concepts, but still for this point of view, this should be more than enough to understand that this will give minimum envelope distortion. We can further, write in other terms that say that this should be greater than or equal to is the sufficient condition. Say message signal, it varies with respect to voltage. Say any variation in the message signal can have maximum or minimum. So if you can have this kind of mathematical relation, this gives a condition for no envelope distortion. So this is a form of saying we'll not have any observed conditions at the output of envelope detector. We can write in other parameters that we know that instantaneous frequency of FM modulated wave, as we know, this is FC plus KF times M of T. The frequency deviation delta F that we know is the difference or the maximum difference between FI and FC. Okay, of course, because FI is a variable with respect to T here, FC, how much amount of frequency is getting deviated from the fixed carrier frequency. Okay, so this is nothing but, this is maximum of FI minus FC is nothing but maximum of KF times M of T. Since KF is a constant, I can write this as KF times maximum of M of T. So this comes back to the relation that we have already written. So this for no distortion is FC should be greater than or equal to your frequency deviation itself. I think we have taken one example in the last session about a numerical on the angle modulation, where I talked about the actual values of these carrier frequency and delta F. Just to revisit that, usually your carrier frequency for FM wave, as I told, it varies from 88 to around 108 megahertz, and your frequency deviation practically or commercially that you use is in the order of you can maximum frequency deviation given the maximum frequency content in the message signal, say if for the audio signal, say around 10 kilohertz would be the practical value, and for beta setting around 10 or 20, say 10, what is delta F in this case? Delta F, that we know that delta F by FM is beta, so delta F is beta times FM, so this is in the order of 100 kilohertz. Okay, so now as you can see, delta F is in the order of around 100 kilohertz, or say 0.1 megahertz, but your carrier frequency is in the order of several hundreds of megahertz. So that is the practical scenario where you eventually set FC to be much greater than delta F, so as to have no envelope distortion at the detector part. Okay, so this is one of the direct method or one of the straightforward method to detect the message signal or demodulate the message signal using your slope detector plus envelope detector. Next we'll move on to a phase locked loop if you don't have any questions.
So
let's move on. Yes.
Can you ask the PSI?
Yes.
Yeah. Please call down a little.
Okay.
Can you explain how you got greater than or equal to from the previous time? Because it says FC is much, much greater than KF of MFT. So, could you explain how you got the equal to again?
Okay. Okay. So this is the stringent condition set for carrier frequency, where if FC is much greater than KF times M of T, you'll have minimum variations of message signal on its envelope. Okay, that's the first condition that I had put. But if this condition is very hard to achieve, say if this condition is very difficult to achieve, you can as well say that since M of T varies with voltage signals, since it's a message signal, we consider that it's some random signal which is varying with respect to voltage. So it will have certain minima and maxima in its voltage levels. So it's enough that if you have set, or if you can extract the maximum voltage in a message signal, instead of simple M of T, if you, you simply eliminate the fact that you consider all the voltage variations, if you can just extract the maximum voltage level of message signal and try to multiply with KF in the same inequality, that would be enough that if you can set FC greater than or equal to. In a sense, if you have, even if it is for equality, for most of the variations, this condition holds good. Okay, that's all was the intention there.
Okay, thank you.
We'll move on to the second type of demodulation, which is known as, this is an important part of any transceivers called PLL. Okay, so PLL is commonly used for not only for FM demodulation, but it is used for several other purposes. Say for carrier synchronization in digital communication, where if you want to sync with the carrier sent from the transmitter, and in various other modules, you may see the uses of a phase lock loop. It has been inherent part of any electronic circuitry in communication systems. Okay, so it is also used in our case here. It has indirect frequency demodulation. We'll try to see its qualitative analysis. Basically, it consists of three important elements. We'll try to draw the PLL first. So it has three important elements. First one is known as, this block is known as loop filter. And it has got another block in it, another important block in it, called as voltage controlled oscillator. So this that we have studied in modulation. So this is VCO. Okay. So there is incoming FM signal, which gets multiplied with the output of voltage controlled oscillator, is fed to the loop filter, and this voltage controlled oscillator gets back in the loop. Okay, hence it is called as loop. We'll try to understand why it is called as phase locking. Okay, so one by one we'll try to understand. So the incoming wave, which is FM wave, here it is S of T. Okay, so the loop filter, the input of the loop filter is multiplication of this S of T, and the voltage signal generated by a voltage control oscillator, which is R of T, and with that multiplication we'll get some signal, say E of T. I'll talk about all these mathematical equations in this session. All right. The voltage control oscillator, or in short it is VCO, this actually performs frequency modulation of its own. Okay, so this also does the job of, you know, frequency modulation of its own. We'll see how this does on its own. Okay, and there is another important block, which is a loop filter. Loop filter is, in fact, is a low pass filter, so which passes only the low frequency components and tries to discard any high frequency content in the system. Okay, so this actually recovers or rejects high frequency components. Okay, so it's, hence it's a low pass filter. All right, so another important block here is the multiplier, which multiplies the incoming FM wave with the voltage signal generated by the VCO itself. Okay, so this does the job of multiplication. So this does S of T multiplied with R of T. Okay, so these are the important blocks of a PLL. We'll try to understand analytically or conceptually how this exactly happens. Incoming FM wave, so I'll go with analysis. So the incoming FM wave, as you know, S of T is AC, can take either sine or cos, anything is fine. I'll take so since all along we have taken, you know, the cos term, that's fine. That if you take, you know, sine is also, that is okay, because both have, you know, similar variation. Sine 2 pi f c t plus phi 1 of t, where I have taken, okay, this, let this be equation 1, where this phi 1 of t that you know already is nothing but 2 pi kf integral 0 to t m of tau d tau. Okay, say the this is the phase, the FM signal produced by VCO itself, the voltage control oscillator, is given as, say this is R of T now, which is, say I'll give some other amplitude here, so I'll give it as AV because it is feeds back from the output of this loop filter. So I'll take it as AV and say this as cos 2 pi FCT plus phi 2 of T. Okay, so where the similar phi 2 here, it's very similar to our received FM signal, but it has an another, you know, frequency sensitivity. They'll be using it as k suffix v or k subscript v integral 0 to t, since it feeds back from v of t data. Okay, so where kv is your frequency sensitivity of t factor, you can say, of the VCO.
So can you just scroll up a little? I just want to see a few of the formulas up.
Okay. All right, so this is where we had, you know, started with. So let's designate some equation numbers. If we have to come back to any of the equations, it will be easy to detect. All right. So the function of this feedback loop that I had, you know, was talking about, the function of this feedback loop around the VCO, so this complete loop around the VCO, is to adjust this phi 2 of t, which is the phase of the locally generated FM wave, this phi 2 of t, to match with this phi 1 of t. Okay, and hence it is called as phase locking. Before the phase locking, it tries to match this phase with respect to the incoming FM wave. So if it these two are equal, then we'll see what will happen. Okay, but the basic idea behind this whole closed loop operation is that tracking of the incoming phase of the FM wave with the locally generated FM signal by VCO itself. Okay, now if you try to multiply equations 1 and 3, which are which does the operation of multiplier, it produces. So what would be the multiplication of equation 1 and equation 4? Say the multiplication of equation 1 and equation 4. I'll not write this explicitly, but sorry, not equation 4. There it is, equation 3, which are time varying signals. So if you try to multiply S of t into R of t, what are all the components that you would be getting? Say this is sine theta into cos theta. Of course, I could have had both sine and both cos, doesn't matter. They are just, you know, differ with respect to their phases. But in this case, if I try to multiply sine A and cos B, what did you get? As you know, with the basic trigonometric relations, sine A into cos B is cos A plus B plus or minus cos A minus B. Okay, so minus will come if A is less than B, plus will come if A is greater than B. Okay, so we can take any of those of addition or subtractions, but it will give two components basically. One is A plus B and A minus B. A plus B is the addition of these two arguments, and A minus B is a difference between these two arguments. So this generates two frequency, two components. One is, okay, if I try to multiply these two, it will give you Km. So I'll take that, Km as multiplication of these two as amplitude times AC times AV. Okay, sine A plus B will give you 4 pi FCT, 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi FCT plus phi 1 of t plus phi 2 of t. Okay, this is A plus B part. So where I have taken this Km as simply as, gain of the multiplier. Say if the multiplier itself has some gain, as you know, the multiplier is implemented using either MOS or BJT, simple common source amplifier will act as a multiplier. Say it will have its own inherent gain in it. So I have taken that Km factor as its inherent gain. Okay, nothing else. Okay, so this is one term. As you can see, this term in its argument has, what is the frequency of this this term? The frequency of this term was, FC. The frequency of this term is what? That double the frequency of the components of S of t and R of t. So this was 2 pi FCT. This is 4 pi FCT. So I can say this is a high frequency component. Okay, it will also give you A minus B term that is nothing but similar with the amplitude. Say the difference between the arguments, say 2 pi FCT minus 2 pi FCT will be canceling each other. It will give you simply the difference between these two phases. Okay, so with the loop filter designed to suppress this high frequency component generated by the multiplier, okay, we may discard this term. We may discard this term because we assume that the loop filter is a high frequency, low pass filter, which rejects the high frequency components in its path and passes only low frequency components. So this is the low frequency component which can be filtered through your loop filter, and hence the loop filter input, the supply of the loop filter, as you can say, filter here is error signal, which is Km AC times AV this is sine. Sine. Can say this as phi e of t, because this is error in the phase now, where phi e of t is the phase error. Okay, so this is nothing but the difference in the phase. Okay, so where I can write this as, I know that phi 2 of t, that we have written phi 2 of t as this equation, I can use that equation as 2 pi kv integral 0 to t we have tau data. Okay, so let us give a few more equation numbers so that if needed we can come back to these points. Error in the phase, this will be exactly equal to zero. Phi of t will be exactly equal to zero if the phase locked loop is in phase lock. In the sense, if there is no error in these phases, which is the phase of the incoming wave and the phase of the locally generated FM wave, if these two are equal with each other, and there will be no phase error at all. Say this phi of, whenever this phi of t is set is zero, we say that our PLL is in phase lock. If there are any errors, okay, say if phi of t approximately equal to say 1 radian, if it's very very small, then also we can ignore that phase lock condition. Okay, so the multiplier job is to multiply the incoming FM signal with the locally generated FM signal by the voltage control oscillator, and should be giving the output, which is the error in the phase. So if the error is larger, the loop tries to adjust itself to minimize this error. If the error is small, then it keeps on performing the same function as it is designed for. Okay, so with that, we can say that the phase lock loop tries to eliminate any errors in the phase and tries to matches with the incoming FM signal. And hence, you can demodulate what is the phase or the frequency content in the FM signal. Okay. If you try to elaborate more into this. Yes, please.
So, the loop filters out the high frequency component, right?
Right.
Which means this KM ACAV sine phi EFT must be the output, right, of the loop filter, right?
Right. In the sense, EFT, if I say. All right. So if I have designated this as input, I'm sorry. That's perfectly right.
Yes.
So this output of phase filter will be the error in the phase, which is also, as you can see, which is also supplied back to the input, right? So the output of the loop filter, as you can see, is supplied back through the voltage control oscillator, and it's fed back to the loop filter, right? So it is it's something like the output of the loop filter is same as the input of itself. Okay, so the E of t will always be will have two frequency contents. One is high frequency and another is the error in the phase. So it is as good as saying, since loop filter performs the rejections of the high frequency components, it always does output of this will be proportional to the error in the phase itself. Okay, so in that sense, since the output of loop filter fed back to the input, I have just used the input and output. V of t is the feedback, of course. So V of t is the feedback, but what is the V of t here? V of t is this function, correct?
Yes, sir. Sir, but in this
V of t
diagram, V show is
this function.
Where it output?
Which come again?
If you
I couldn't hear you
the
properly.
output, it adjusts the phase, right, sir?
Exactly, that's correct. V of t is a output of the loop filter, which is a low frequency component, which is fed back through VCO. Again, it comes to the input of your loop filter. Again, it tries to multiply with your incoming signal S of t, which is your FM signal. So this V of t comes here and tries to multiply with S of t, tries to matches with its frequency, then gives an error signal if there is any. Say, if you don't have any phase error, say if phi 1 of t minus phi 2 of t is 0 itself, what would be the output? What would be the output here?
Zero.
Output would be 0, right? So we don't, output would be 0. So we don't want the output of this loop filter, we want this output of the loop filter to be 0. That means that we have completely matched the incoming FM wave to exactly with the locally generated FM signal. Okay, that's how you recover. So this FM wave, which is sent from the transmitter, say from the transmitter, if S of t is transmitted, when it reaches the receiver, in the channel in V of t, as we see here. Okay, so S of t would be corrupted in its argument. Sin of 2 pi fct plus phi 1 of t plus some other constants would be there in the received signal at the front end of the receiver. Right. So we are trying to negate that any errors in the phase due to the corruptions in the channel that is occurred while it is transmitted from the transmitter. So we try to negate that effect by perform this feedback loop. That's all is the idea behind it. If phi of t, which is the error in the phase, if it pulls down to 0, then we say that the signal or the waveform generated by VCO exactly is identical to the which is sent from the transmitter end. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll try to elaborate a little more about this. If you are not satisfied mathematically with this, I think this analysis will give you a better picture. Okay, so with that, I'll say we'll try to model this filter or the complete PLL itself. Okay, I think this will convince you in a better way, like this. So I'll pick this E of t. Up till this point, everything is fine. Say E of t that we have written as Km AC times AV by E of t. Say this is for small errors t can be approximated to simply phi e of t itself. I just try to avoid all these constants, since all these are simply are the constants. Say I'll rewrite them as, because it involves V of t as a function at the output times Ke of t, where this K naught is nothing but Km times AC times AV. So Km, carrier amplitudes and the output of the loop filter, and KV being the frequency sensitivity factor of your VCO. So all these are constant clubbed together and can be crisply written as in this fashion. Say if you have this function, I can try to, so this another picture of your VCO to make things very clear. Okay, say the incoming signal, I'll not write anything which is required to lock with the locally generated signal. Okay. See, this is generated by your VCO, which is your phi 2 of t. Okay. So if these are try to subtract each other, which will give you an error in the phase. As you know, I need to multiply this phi e of t with a constant k naught by kV. Okay, so there is a multiplier, which is in fact does the operation of, and this k naught by kV times phi e of 2, your loop filter. I assure that this analysis will give you more clarity. So this to the VCO, okay, so this does an operation of, in fact, an integration. This with another term, what should be this? Okay, so this is your V of t. As we know, the R of t term, if I scroll up a little bit, so the locally generated signal from the VCO is nothing but phi 2 of t. How do you obtain phi 2 of t? Phi 2 of t is nothing but 2 pi kV integral 0 to t V of tau d tau. So this is my equation number 4. So utilizing this equation number 4, I have generated V of t and have to integrate that V of t and multiply with 2 pi kV in order to get the phase phi 2 of t. So this is complete picture with respect to their phases. Okay, so I have integrated V of t and try to multiply that with two pi kV to get your signal phi 2 of t, and then you add and subtract these two phases to get another perspective. So how does it, you know, give us a clean picture about the demodulation of FM wave? You know from the feedback theory that you might have studied in your AMC that the gain of the feedback loop, say if it is called as AF, you know that gain of the feedback loop is A by 1 plus beta A, where beta is your feedback gain. Say for AB much greater than unity, say for the gain, if it is simply 1, so you can beta B. Okay, so the closed loop transfer function of this feedback system AF is essentially independent of the forward path, which is simply the inverse of your feedback factor for the condition A beta much greater than 1. Okay, so from this we can write the V of t, the output of your filter V of t, in the reverse fashion. Say this is feedback path, which is coming from get back the input V of t. How do I do it? Say my question is here t. How do I get back V of t from phi 2 of t? I should do the exact reverse operation. So whenever I am multiplying, I should divide it. Whenever I am integrating, I should differentiate it. So in other words, V of t is nothing but 1 over 2 pi kV of d phi 2 of t over dt. Okay, so with this relation between the output and the input in an alternate fashion, this will give you an important conclusion, where assuming as we have assumed here the loop gain parameter to be large. So what is the loop gain parameter here? We have written right before the loop. This is a loop gain parameter. So this is complete the loop gain, which is a product of all the gains in the loop. Say the loop gain, if k naught, okay, so if the k naught is much greater than 1, then it will give you just a minute. I'll write in other fashion. The loop gain parameter because that's scrolling up on the screen. K naught. Okay, let's assume that this is large. This makes the phi E of t approximately very small or close to zero. Okay, so from this equation where we have written phi E of t as this expression, I can rewrite this phi E of t now as E of t times kV by k naught will also approximately equal to zero. So with this condition, when phi E of t much closer to zero, or if it is approximated to zero, this says that and phi 2 of t is also zero. Okay, so this is a condition for your locking of the phase, and hence your V of t, which you have written just above, will be, which is your 1 over 2 pi kV. Now I can replace that phi 2 of t with phi 1 of t itself. This implies your phi 2 of t will be equal to phi 1 of t itself. So with that, I can replace the condition of V of t to be this. Now I can say that V of t is nothing but 1 over 2 pi kV d by dt. I know that what is phi 1? Phi 1 from the generated FM signal. So this is my phi 1, which I have written as equation number 2, which is 2 pi kf integral 0 to t m of tau d tau. So I'll just write the same expression for phi of 1 as 2 pi kf integral 0 to t m of tau d tau. So this will give you what? Simply, if I differentiate and integrate, this will cancel each other. So 2 pi kf and 2 pi kv will give you kf by kv, and this will give you simply m of t. So this is the output of your loop filter, which is proportional to the message signal. So this proves that the output of your loop filter, which is v of t, is in accordance with the message signal, and hence you can say you can recover the message signal. So this states that when the system operates in the phase locked loop, so this is a condition for phase locked loop. For to have phase locked loop, the loop gain parameter should be much larger, such that the error in the phase is approximately equal to zero. So whenever it is in the mode of phase lock or near phase lock, the loop gain parameter k naught is also large compared with unity, and hence your frequency demodulation or the recovery of your message signal is accomplished, as your output of the loop filter is proportional to message m of t itself. Okay, that's how you can concisely say that if you try to model in other ways, you can say that the message signal is recovered using your PLL.